Hello students, so here we are to solve the numericals related to pressure in fluids. And atmospheric pressure. First we put down all the formulas related to it. We already know the basic formula about pressure, that pressure is said to be thrust upon area, thrust, or you can call it as force, thrust upon area, which is abbreviated as P is equals to F upon A. Okay, this is your first formulation. But when it is in case of liquids, the pressure in liquid, we measure it as H into rho into G, where H stands for the height or the depth, or we call it as the depth of liquid or water. Rho is the density and G is your gravity. Yes, it is known. And if they ask you total pressure, then it will be atmospheric pressure plus the pressure in liquid or pressure due to liquid column. So atmospheric pressure is denoted as P0 and this is your P. Ultimately your formula becomes P0 or PO plus H rho G. This becomes the formula for total pressure which is exerted. Then we have numericals related to this thing, the pistons, the hydraulic machines. So according to Pascal's law, there are two forces acting. So the F2 upon F1 corresponding to the areas A2 upon A1, where F1 and A1 are related to the smaller piston, F2 and A2 are related to the larger piston. So when the pressure is applied, it is equally transmitted in all directions. So from the first piston, the pressure is exerted on the other piston, whose areas are different. Therefore, different forces will be acting upon them. And that's why they are called as force multiplier that we are going to use. Even you can use the reciprocal of this. You can write it as F1 upon F2 is equal to A1 upon A2. That is also okay. And there is one numerical related to Boyle's law. Which states that pressure into volume P1 V1 is equals to P2 V2 when the temperature is constant. Temperature is not related over here. So just mention about P1 V1 is equal to P2 into V2. Okay. These are the numericals. These are the formulations. Or kuch formulations. Yeah, related to altitude aa sakta hai. Problems related to altitude. How does the pressure changes? With ascent. As you climb up the mountain, there is change in the pressure level. At sea level it is suppose 76, wo upar jaake kahin pe jaake 60 ho jayega. So how much distance, what is the height of the mountain, aise puchhenge. So the conversion factor they will give you, will be given to you in the problem. Only you have to find the decrease in the decrease in pressure will be original minus new. Bas ye yaad rakho, original pressure minus new pressure, whatever is the difference, that you will apply over here for cross multiplication. I'll be proceeding, matlab jaise jaise problems aayenge I will be helping you out in this. Okay, so just go through this, put up on the paper so that easier for you all to refer with the numericals. Okay, so we start with the first question or first numerical of the chapter of pressure. A boy weighing 60 kilogram force, weight, that is your thrust. So for a boy, the force, that is the thrust, let it be F1, is 60 kilogram force. Is wearing shoes with a hill of area, of cross section, A1, is 20 centimeter square. It's okay. While a girl, weighing, weight is your force, is your thrust, is 45 kilogram force, nothing to get confused, is wearing sandals with a heel of cross section area 1.5 centimeter square. Area A2 is 1.5 centimeter square. compare the pressure exerted. So here we want first the pressure, here we want the pressure, and then we'll compare them. So according to this solution, here P1 is always equals to F1 upon A1. Pressure is equals to force upon area. Therefore P1 is equals to F1 is 60 upon A is 20. Cancellation gives me 0, 0, 2, 1, 3. Pressure, the unit for pressure is normally Pascal, but this is given in kilogram force. So we better write kilogram force per centimeter square. So this is the pressure exerted by the boy on the ground. And then the second one, that is the pressure exerted by the girl, that is F2 upon A2, which is P2 is equals to F2 is 45 and area is 1.5. When I shift the decimal, it becomes 450 upon 15, because I have shifted one decimal, so one extra zero in the numerator. It becomes 15 ones are 15, threes are and zero. So the pressure exerted by the girl is 30 kilogram force per centimeter square. So these are the two answers. But in the question, they have asked not only to find the pressure, but the comparison. Compare the pressure exerted by their heels when they stand on the hill of 1 foot. Okay, so when there is a comparison, we are supposed to find the ratio, that is P2 upon P1 low or P1 upon P2, koi bhi chalega. So P2, the greater number I have taken up, so it is 30 upon 3, 3 ones are 3 tens are, therefore P2 upon P1 is equals to 10. So when you cross multiply, you get P2 is 10 times P1, that is P2, P2 is girl, that means the pressure exerted by the girl is 10 times more than the pressure exerted by the boy. Therefore, write your final answer, that is the pressure exerted by the girl is 10 times more than the boy. Okay, this is your first numerical. Nothing, very simple data was provided, force and area was given, force and area was given, just to find the pressures and to compare them. Compare ka matlab hai, ratio find out karo aur cross multiply karke 2 times, 3 times, 5 times, kuch bhi ek number aayega. So therefore P2 has become 10 times P1, ka matlab hoga that pressure exerted by the girl is 10 times that of boy. Okay? Okay, your next question, that is example number 6.2. It is a square plate of side, square plate whose side is, square plate whose side is given to be 10 meters is placed horizontally 1 meter below the surface of the water. Surface means free surface of the water. Matlab ye ho gaya aapka height. Height is 1 meter below the free surface of water. And the atmospheric pressure yani ke original pressure, we write it as original pressure. Original pressure is 1.013 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square. Okay, calculate the total thrust. Total thrust yani ke force chahiye. Total thrust, if the density of water is given to be 10 raised to 3 kilogram per meter cube, and value of g is given 9.8 meters per second square. Now since you want the thrust yani force chahiye, we have the formula that pressure is equals to force upon area. Iska matlab to find the force I require pressure into area. To pehle to pressure nikalna padega, total pressure nikalna padega. So now the total pressure kaise milega? To first find the pressure, atmospheric pressure to diya hua hai, lekin pressure exerted by the plate wo kitna hoga. So first of all, we'll find the pressure by the plate. Pressure on the plate, normal formula for pressure is H into rho into G. H into rho into G. H is, height is how much? 1 meter. Density is 10 raised to 3 and gravity is 9.8. So when you multiply, just listen to the calculation. 1, 2, 3 zeros into 9.8. When you multiply, it becomes 98.12 pressure. Pressure is in Pascal or Newton per meter square. Now since this other pressure is given in 10 raised to 5 form, we take the decimals piche. Here the decimal is here, suppose. So if we go behind, how many places? 5 places. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Ek zero aa jayega. 0.098. This becomes into 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter cube, meter square. Okay. So this is your pressure. Okay. To find the total pressure exerted, the total pressure exerted will be the pressure on the plate plus the atmospheric pressure. We write it as P plus P zero. Pressure is 0.098 into 10 raised to 5 plus the atmospheric pressure is given 1.013 into 10 raised to 5. If I take this 10 raised to 5 common, to bracket mein aega 0.098 plus 1.013 ek bracket mein into common wala 10 raised to 5. So this addition karke dekhte hai 0.098 or 1.013. 1.111 into 10 raised to 5. It has come out to be this is your total pressure, Newton per meter square. Okay? So, ye mil gaya apne ko pressure, total pressure. Chalo, usko baad mein use karenge. Now, the area find out kar lenge, area. But since it is a square plate, the area of square plate is equals to side square. So it will be 10 into 10, which is 100 meter square. Getting it? You mil gaya? So now I want the force. Therefore the total thrust, as I told you, the formula is total pressure into the area, the area on which the force is acting. So the total pressure we got is 1.111 into 10 raised to 5 multiply by the area is 100. So when you multiply this, it gives you, this will remain 1.111 into 10 raised to, this is 5, 6 and 7, total 7 zeros. So 7 zeros thrust, force is given in Newton. So therefore your final answer is total thrust is 1.111 into 10 raised to 7 Newton. Very simple one. एक container था, उसके अंदर plate एक डाला गया, एक plate रखा गया है free surface से कितना height के ऊपर, 1 meter की height के ऊपर, and उसका density भी दिया है, gravity भी दिया है. तो first we found the pressure exerted on the plate. बट टोटल प्रेशर बोला है, इसके लिए पी जीरो को भी ऐड कर देंगे. इसके लिए दिस इज योर पी, यहां पर मिलेगा पी प्लस पी जीरो विल गिव यू द टोटल प्रेशर. तो दिस इज योर टोटल प्रेशर विच इज एक्टिंग एंड द स्क्वायर प्लेट. तो उसका एरिया चाहिए, एरिया ऑफ द प्लेट. सिंस इट इज अ स्क्वायर, इट इज साइड स्क्वायर. 10 into 10 गिव्स यू 100 एंड देयर फॉर फोर्स इज इक्वल्स टू प्रेशर इंटू एरिया. जस्ट मल्टीप्लाइड एंड योर आंसर. गॉट इट? दिस वॉज योर एग्जाम्पल नंबर 6.2. ओके, द नेक्स्ट वन इज योर question number, example number 6.3, which says that there is a YouTube jiske andar it is partially filled with mercury. To mercury ka level dono side pe same hai initially. Okay, this is your mercury. Now if water is added in one, यहाँ पर हम लोग ने water add किया, ये क्या है, water is added, and oil, यहाँ पर हम लोग ने oil add किया, in the two arms, calculate the ratio of water and oil, मतलब we are supposed to find this height h1 और इसको हम लोग लेते हैं h2, किसका, water with respect to water and oil, मतलब we want h1 is to h2, ये दोनों का ratio क्या रहेगा, the height of the water as well as the oil, ratio दोनों का चाहिए.
सो दैट द मर्क्यूरी लेवल इन द इज सेम इन द टू आर्म्स. मतलब इवन इफ वी एड सम लिक्विड टू इट नॉर्मली ऑन वन साइड और ऑन अदर साइड ऑल्सो बोथ द साइड्स द लेवल मे चेंज. बट वॉट इज हैपनिंग ओवर हियर इज द बिकॉज ऑफ सर्टन डिफरेंस इन द हाइट वेन वाटर एंड ऑयल आर एडेड स्टिल द मर्क्यूरी लेवल रिमेन्स द सेम एंड दे हैव गिवन अस द डेंसिटी ऑफ वाटर. Density of water is given to us. It is 10^3 kilogram per meter cube, and they have given us the density of oil, which is 900 kilogram per meter cube. Okay. Now, since they have said that mercury level remains the same, iska matlab the pressure acting on both sides is same. Since solution will say that. Since the mercury level is same in both arms, we can say that the pressure due to water column should equal to the pressure due to oil. What is the formula for pressure? It is H into rho into G. Here also the formula is H into rho into G. But here it is for water. So I take H1, rho1. Gravity is constant. Height for water, for oil, 2 and 2. So yahan par, this is your rho1 and this is your rho2. Okay. When I substitute the values, uske pehle G and G will cancel. So you are left out with H1, rho1. Is equals to H2 rho2. So what is your H1? ये तो अपने को चाहिए है. Into rho1. Rho1 is 10^3. 10^3 equal to H2 we want. Into rho2 is 900. Okay. So if I take this down, H1 upon H2 will equal to 900 upon 10^3 is 1000. So what happens is two zeros cancel. We are left out with 9 upon 10 is what? It is 0.9. Iska matlab H1 will equal to 0.9 times H2. Ratio pucha tha, if you leave the answer over here, to bhi chalega. 9 upon 10 tak rakh diya, to bhi chalega. Because specifically they said calculate the ratio. To ratio to lucky rakho. Ye to relation ho gaya, comparison ho gaya. To phir bhi comparison agar pucha, to hum log likhenge, therefore the height of water column, height of water column, that is H1, ये कितना है? It is 0.9 times the height of oil का column. Okay, simple one. खाली diagrammatically बराबर से समझ लो, तो it will be easier for you all. Okay, this is your third example. Okay, so proceeding with example number 6.4. There they say that at what depth means they want the height kitna hai, at what depth below the surface of water will pressure, matlab at this height jo pressure hai na, matlab they mean to say the pressure at depth h is how much, is equal to twice the atmospheric pressure, two times atmospheric pressure is denoted by PO, बराबर है, टू टाइम्स द एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर. ओके, देन दे हैव सेड दैट द एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर PO इज ऑलरेडी गिवन टू बी 10 न्यूटन पर सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर. सर ये नहीं चलेगा, सेंटीमीटर ये CGS यूनिट हो गया. तो फर्स्ट वी नीड टू कन्वर्ट दिस, सो इट विल बिकम 10 अपॉन, ये दो बार सेंटीमीटर है, वन मीटर इज इक्वल्स टू 100 सेंटीमीटर, लेकिन अपने पास दो बार है, तो इट वी डिवाइड बाई 100 टू टाइम्स, 100 इंटू 100. सो इट इज गोइंग टू बिकम ये 10 ऐसे रहेगा, और ये है 10^4 जीरोज है, तो raised to 4, बराबर है, raised to 4 एंड सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर. विच विल सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर नीचे की तरफ है, मतलब ऊपर लेना पड़ेगा. तो इट इज़ इंटू 100 इंटू 100, तो ये बन जाएगा, इफ़ आई मल्टीप्लाई बाई 100 into 100 इट विल बिकम न्यूटन इंटू मीटर स्क्वायर, यानी ये कितना हो गया 10^1, 2, 3, 4, 5 10^5 न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर, ये बन गया एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर का वैल्यू, एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर का वैल्यू। नाउ दे हैव सेड सॉल्यूशन, सॉल्यूशन मतलब क्या, अच्छा उसके पहले डेटा लिख देता हूँ, और क्या दिया हुआ है, डेंसिटी ऑफ वाटर इज गिवेन, रो ऑफ वाटर इज गिवेन 10^3 kg पर मीटर क्यूब, एंड दे हैव गिवेन द वैल्यू ऑफ जी एज 9.8 मीटर पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर। ओके, सो नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस दे हैव सेड दैट द प्रेशर एट डेप्थ एच इज इक्वल्स टू द टोटल प्रेशर, बराबर है, पहले तो टोटल प्रेशर, दैट इज़ द टोटल प्रेशर, टोटल प्रेशर मतलब क्या होगा, एक तो एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर प्लस द प्रेशर ड्यू टू वाटर कॉलम, ओके वाटर कॉलम। नाउ प्रेशर एट डेप्थ एच इज हाउ मच, इट इज़ 2 times द एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर, एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर इज अगेन पी ओ, एंड प्रेशर ड्यू टू वाटर इज गिवन बाई एच इंटू रो इंटू जी, गेटिंग इट, इसको इधर ले लेते हैं, तो 2 times पी ओ माइनस पी ओ इज इक्वल्स टू एच रो जी, 2 - 1 = 1, तो खाली बन गया पी ओ इज इक्वल्स टू एच रो एंड जी। नाउ सब्सटीट्यूट द वैल्यूज, पी ओ हाउ मच इज पी ओ, जस्ट नाउ वी गॉट इट इज 10^5 इज इक्वल्स टू हाइट वी आर सपोज टू फाइंड, डेंसिटी ऑफ वाटर इज गिवन 10^3 एंड ग्रेविटी इज गिवन 9.8, चलेगा, तो एच फाइंड आउट करने के लिए वी नीड टू टेक ऑल दिस डाउन, देयरफॉर एच इज इक्वल्स टू 10^5 एज इट इज अपॉन में 10^3 इंटू 9.8। लुक एट द सॉल्यूशन पार्ट, ये 3 को मैं ऊपर लूँगा तो इट विल बिकम 10^5 माइनस 3 अपॉन में 9.8 एज इट इज रहेगा, तो दिस विल बिकम 10² अपॉन 9.8, दिख रहा है ना, दिख रहा है, ओके okay? अभी इसी को ही 10² इज वॉट 100, ये 100 है और एक पॉइंट शिफ्ट किया, मतलब ये बन गया 1000 upon 98, बराबर है 1000 upon 98। अभी इसको सॉल्व करके देखते हैं, डिवीजन करके देखते हैं, 1000 upon 98, ये थ्री डिजिट, 98 1 = 98 कितना बचा 2, और ये 0 नहीं जाता है, तो 0 = 0, 20 लेफ्ट, नाउ टेक द डेसिमल, तो और एक 0 आएगा, 98 2 = 196, 4 बचा, लीव इट, 1 place मिल गया आंसर, देयरफॉर दिस इज इक्वल्स टू 10.2, हाइट इज गिवन इन मीटर्स, इसका मतलब योर फाइनल आंसर द हाइट इज 10.2 meters, ओवर, सिंपल, खाली थोड़ा कंफ्यूज करने के लिए दे हैड गिवन दैट रिलेशन दैट प्रेशर एट पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट इज 2 times, तो 2 times द प्रेशर एंड द प्रेशर, और हम तो हम लोग का जो सॉल्यूशन है उसके अंदर सब कॉम्प्लिकेट करके दिया हुआ है, वैल्यूज डायरेक्ट सब्सटीट्यूट किया है ना, इसके लिए वो थोड़ा कॉम्प्लिकेटेड हो गया, ये एकदम इजी मेथड हो गया अपना, ओके जस्ट गो थ्रू इट, ओके सो वी प्रोसीड विद द प्रॉब्लम्स फ्रॉम द असाइनमेंट, असाइनमेंट 1 इन दैट द प्रॉब्लम नंबर द न्यूमेरिकल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, सो द सिक्स्थ न्यूमेरिकल फ्रॉम द असाइनमेंट 1, इट सेज कैलकुलेट द प्रेशर पी इज इक्वल्स टू हाउ मच, कैलकुलेट द प्रेशर ऑफ द वॉटर कॉलम ऑफ हाइट, हाइट इज गिवेन टू बी 100 meters, टेकिंग इन द ब्रैकेट दे हैव गिवेन स्पेसिफाइड अजम्पशन इज गिवेन एज जी का वैल्यू 10 meters per second square एंड डेंसिटी दैट इज योर रो ऑफ द वॉटर इज 10^3 किलोग्राम पर मीटर क्यूब, ओके सो वी नीड टू सॉल्व, सिंपल वन, there is nothing related to atmospheric pressure, so simple formula for the pressure acting on the pressure of the water column, so the pressure of the water column is given by h into rho into g, therefore p is equals to your h is 100 into your rho is 10^3 into g is 10, therefore your pressure becomes, calculate the number of zeros yahan par 10^3 matlab there are 3 zeros, 3, 4, 5 and 6, totally 6 zeros, matlab 10^6 pressure is given in newton per meter square, or even you could have written pascal, therefore the pressure exerted by the water column is this much, that is 10 raised to 6 newton per meter square. Okay, so from assignment number 1 we are doing the seventh question, which says that the base of a cylindrical vessel measures this much centimeter square. Matlab this is the area, centimeter square ka matlab hota hai area. So area of the base is given 300 centimeter square, but the data is in kilogram per meter square. So isko bhi meter mein convert karna padega. So 300 upon 100 into 100, because centimeter square hai na, centimeter do bar hai, matlab ye ek centimeter ka aur ye dusre centimeter ka. So we divide 2 times by 100, so it will become in meter square. Okay, leave it as it is, cancellation mat karo, baad mein karenge. Then water whose density of water is given, density of water is given 1000 kg per meter cube. Iske liye main I converted this into meter square. Then ek minute, data yeah 1000 is poured into it up to a depth of, the height up to which the water is taken is 6 centimeter. Wapas se it is given in centimeter, so we convert it 6 upon 100, so it becomes in meter. So this is the depth of the water. So from this data you are supposed to find first the pressure exerted and also the thrust. Thrust is the force, and the value of G is said to be 10 meters per second square. Okay, so first of all we require the pressure. Pressure ke liye the direct formula was pressure is equals to H into rho into G. Therefore the pressure exerted is, height is how much, 6 upon 100 G, density is how much, directly 1000, and G is how much, kidhar gaya G, 10, G is 10. Okay, so I go for the cancellation, 1 with 1 and one more 0 with one more 0. Therefore P remains 6 into 100, which is 600 pascals likho ya newton per meter square likho. That is your pressure. Once you get the pressure, you can find the thrust, because we know the formula for pressure, that is the pressure exerted is thrust upon the area, but we want thrust. Therefore you can say that thrust is equals to whatever is the pressure multiply by the area. So your pressure just now we got how much, 600 pascals, and area is how much, after conversion it was 300 upon 100 and one more 100. So how many zeros cancel, 1 2 1 2, and one more 1 2 and 1 2. So left is only 6 into 3, and therefore your thrust acting is 6 into 3 is 18. Force is given in Newton, therefore 18 Newton. Getting it? Simple. Data provided tha. Iske liye pressure first we got by using H rho G and got 600 Pascal. The way pressure ka value we substituted in the thrust formula and we got the answer for thrust. Got it? This is your 7th one. Here the 8th is a very 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 important problem. Very important problem. Pressure of water on the ground floor. Look at this, if you are able to. Okay, here there is a building. Here this is your ground. Here there is a top. Here this is your first floor. Here this is your first floor. Okay, let me assume this as the total height. I use capital H, and from the top free surface say up to the first floor, let the height be small h. Chalega? Barabar se samjho jara. Now the pressure of the water on the ground floor, pressure up to the ground is 40,000 Pascal, and at the first floor pressure on the first floor is 10,000 pascals. Find the height of the building, find the height of the first floor. We are supposed to find the height of the first floor, and the assumptions are given to you. They have given that the density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube and g ka value is 10 meters per second square. We are supposed to find the height of the first floor. Height of first floor. Look at the logic we are using. First, look at the total height of the building. Total height of the building. Barabar hai? Dekho jara. Solution mein, the pressure exerted up to the ground. Okay? Up to the ground. So, up to the ground ke liye formula H into rho into G. That is, H is height is, we don't know. We have taken capital H. Okay? Rho is 1000. And G is 10. And the pressure exerted is already given on the ground 40,000. So, to find this capital H, what we do is, this 40,000 upon, or take all the numbers, 1000 and 10. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, H mil gaya. H is 4 meters. Ye H kya hai? The total height of the building. Therefore, the height of the building from top to ground level is 4 meters. Chalega? Okay. Abhi hum log first floor talak hi dekhenge. We'll see up to first floor. So, second part ke liye, now I am doing pressure exerted up to first floor. Again, it is H into rho into G. Pressure exerted is 10,000 Pascal. H is how much? H we don't know. Rho is how much? 1000. G is how much? 10. Therefore, calculating it, we get H is equals to this 10,000 divided by 1000 into 10. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, height becomes 1 meter. Ye height kaun sa height hai? Which is this height? This is the height up to first floor. Therefore, height from top to first floor is how much? 1 meter. But we want the height of the building, height of the first floor. Therefore, the final answer, height of the first floor will equal to the height from top to ground minus the height from top to the first floor. Yani, I mean to say, it is capital H minus small h. Capital H we had got 4 meters and small h we had got 1 meter. So, it comes out to be 3 meters. Therefore, this is the height of the first floor. Therefore, the height of the first floor is 3 meters. Just check the answer. Getting it? Are you able to see? View ho raha hai barabar se? Chala dekh lo. Yeah. Proper view. Kuch nahi samjha to rewind karke dekh sakte ho. I have divided the problem into two parts. By first finding the total height, because the total pressure was given. Then I found the height up to the first floor, that is your small h, using the pressure up to first floor. Usse kya mila mujhe? Capital H or small h. When I subtract the capital H and the small h, what I get is the height of up to the first floor. Height from the ground to the first floor. Yani, first floor ka height I have got 3 meters. Okay? Pay attention. Okay? So, a new type of problem based on the plunger or the hydraulic machines. Here it is an example from your textbook, that is example number 6.5. Here a force of 50 kilogram force is applied on a smaller piston. So here I take the two parts, that is a smaller piston and a large piston. Okay, large piston. Normally what are the denotations over here? Here the force acting is F1 and the area is written as A1. Here the force is written as F2 and the area is written as A2. Okay, let us see. Kya kya diya hai? A force of 50 kilogram force is applied on the force. On the smaller piston is 50 kilogram force on the smaller piston of a hydraulic machine. Neglecting the friction, okay, find the force exerted on the larger piston. Yani F2 apne ko find out karna hai. The diameters, area nahi diya hai, but the diameter is given. D1 is given. Diameter of the pistons are 5 and 25. Okay, so here it is 5 centimeter and here the diameter D2 is 25 centimeters. So in the chapter, actually in the chapter, we don't have anything related to diameter mentioned. So what I do is, to find the area, I need the radius. So pehle main iska radius find out kar leta hun. Radius is always half of the diameter, yani D1 upon 2. That is, it becomes 5 upon 2 centimeter. Let it be. इधर भी रेडियस फाइंड आउट कर लेते हैं. R2 इज इक्वल्स टू D2 सेकेंड डायमीटर अपॉन 2, यानी कि 25 अपॉन 2. डोंट गो फॉर डेसिमल्स, इजी ऐसे ही रहने दो और इसको इजीली सॉल्व करेंगे हम लोग. ओके, लेट अस सी. नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू प्रिंसिपल ऑफ हाइड्रोलिक मशीन, अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ हाइड्रोलिक मशीन, वी नो दैट दैट अकॉर्डिंग टू प्रिंसिपल ऑफ hydraulic machine, we know that F2 upon F1 is equals to A2 upon A1. Okay, that is F2 upon F1 is equals to A2 upon A1, but A1 and A2 are not given. So area of a circle, what is the area of a circle? Yani piston jo hota hai wo circular hota hai. So area of the circle is written as pi r square. So here I will be mentioning R2 ka square upon pi R1 का square. Getting it? So here pi and pi cancels. So what is left is, whatever is left, अभी इसमें से देखो वापस से लिख देता हूँ. Therefore F2 upon F1 is equals to this R2 का square upon R1 का square. What is your F2? No, I don't know. That is F2 as it is रखा. Upon F1 is 50. R2 का square. R2 is 25 upon 2. 25 upon 2 the whole square. Upon R1 is 5 upon 2 the whole square. Look at it, how do I solve? Therefore F2 upon this 50 is equals to 25 upon 2 ka square. 25 ka is 6, 25 upon 4 full upon 5 ka square, 25 full upon 2 ka square 4. You can see both the denominators have 4 and 4 in the denominator, so it will cancel. So what we are left out with is F2 upon 50 is equals to this 625 upon 25. Cross multiply this 50, therefore you can get the second force, that is 625 upon 25, and this is multiplied by 50. So what I do is 25 2's are is 50, so multiply 625 with 2, 2 5's are 10, 4 and 5 and 6 2's are 12. Force is this many. The original force was given in kilogram force, so this is also in kilogram force. Therefore the force acting on the large piston will be 1250 kilogram force. Getting it? Thoda simplify karke diya, thoda lengthy ho gaya hai, but it is easier. Okay, now example number 6.6. Here there is a diagrammatic question. You can see in the diagram there are piston A and piston B. There is piston A and piston B. Okay. So in this diagram, alongside the area of cross section of piston A and B are given. Yani A1 is given to be 8 centimeter square and A2, yani second piston ka area is 320 centimeter square. Okay. Then respectively, और डायग्राम में अगर देखोगे तो लुक एट द डायग्राम, स्मॉलर पिस्टन के ऊपर फोर्स कितना है, यानी F1 एक्टिंग इज 4 किलोग्राम फोर्स, दिख रहा है ना फ्रॉम द डायग्राम। डेटा मेंशन नहीं किया है बट डायग्राम के अंदर मेंशन किया है, लोड रखा हुआ है 4 किलोग्राम फोर्स का। सो नाउ द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज प्रेशर एट ए, प्रेशर एट ए। तो सॉल्यूशन फॉर द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, प्रेशर pressure at A will equal to the thrust upon area. What is the thrust given to you? The thrust given, force is 4 and area is 8. Cancellation 4 1s and 2s. 1 upon 2 is 0.5. Pressure is given in, pressure is given in kilogram force per centimeter square, because thrust is in kilogram force and area is centimeter square. Therefore, this is the pressure at the piston A, बराबर है। Then you want pressure at B, अरे लेकिन ये तो hydraulic machine है, equal pressure is exerted on both sides, तो इसका मतलब pressure at कब क्या बोला है B will always be equal to the pressure at A. Because according to Pascal law, equal pressure is transmitted. Equal pressure is transmitted when the force is applied. बराबर है? So, the pressure at B will be same as pressure at A. Pressure at A कितना मिला? 0.5. Therefore, this is also 0.5 kilogram force per centimeter square. So, this is the answer for the second part. That is pressure at B. Okay? Okay. Name and state the principle. Simple. Pascal's law. It is? Pascal's law, and then name and state यार पूरा को लिखना पड़ेगा, definition लिखना पड़ेगा। चलो definition लिख देते हैं। Whenever a pressure is applied at any point of an enclosed liquid, what happens is it gets transmitted equally and undiminished in all directions. This statement I have explained in my video, in all directions throughout the liquid. So this is your statement for Pascal's law. Okay, so now if from this answers yahan par piston B ke liye pressure jo tha wo mil gaya apne ko, to pressure at B, pressure yani ke P2 mil gaya apne ko, kitna mila? 0.5 kilogram force per centimeter square. Now you want is, what you want is calculate the thrust on the piston B. So for the fourth question, we have that thrust on piston B will equal to the pressure into area. So what is the pressure? We got 0.5. What is the area? Area is how much? It is 320. So just multiply. I am not looking at the decimals and not looking at zeros. 5 into 2, 10. 5 is 15 and 16. 1, 6 and there is extra 0. So, ye 0 put kiya. Point after one place. Either. So, point goes, it remains only 160. And since it is thrust yani force. So, it is 160 Newton. 160 Newton, yeah. But yeah, this answer was in kilogram force. So, here we put kilogram force. Okay. That is your answer for thrust on piston B. Easy? Very interesting problem. बहुत ही interesting problem था, intelligent problem बोल सकता हूँ इसको। बहुत कुछ data दिया था, diagram में से सब कुछ निकालना था, statement भी पूछ लिया। ये तो कम से कम यूके देविलास के और 4 marks के लिए तो पूछेंगे ही ये। Okay. The next one, that is your example number 6.7. It says about the press plunger of a hydraulic machine, press plunger, yani ke smaller piston, barabar hai? तो ये है अबाउट द प्रेस प्लंजर ऑफ हाइड्रोलिक मशीन हुज एरिया A1 इज 4 meter square इन क्रॉस सेक्शन एंड इज रिक्वायर्ड टू ओवरकम अ रेजिस्टिव लोड फोर्स इज 400 किलोग्राम फोर्स F1 इज 400 किलोग्राम फोर्स. कैलकुलेट द फोर्स रिक्वायर्ड. दूसरा पंप प्लंजर. दिस इज योर पंप प्लंजर. तो कैलकुलेट हाउ मच फोर्स F2 विल बी हाउ मच ऑन द पंप प्लंजर इफ द एरिया ऑफ द क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ द प्लंजर इज एरिया A2 इज 0.01 meter square. सिंपल डेटा इज प्रोवाइडेड. तो अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ पास्कल्स लॉ वी नो द स्टेटमेंट दैट F2 अपॉन F1 इज इक्वल्स टू A2 अपॉन A1. वट इज योर F2? दैट इज वॉट वी वॉन्ट. अपॉन F1 इट इज 400 किलोग्राम फोर्स. वट इज A2? इट इज 0.01. अपॉन वट इज A1? इट इज 4. जस्ट क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई. देयरफॉर F2 इज इक्वल्स टू, ये तो पॉइंट को शिफ्ट कर दो प्लेसेस इधर शिफ्ट होगा तो 2 zeros विल कम डाउन. तो इट विल बिकम 1 upon 400 एंड इनटू ये क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई किया दैट 400. सो देयरफॉर F2 हैज बिकम ये 400 कैंसिल. ओनली 1 इज लेफ्ट. हियर द फोर्स वाज गिवन इन किलोग्राम फोर्स. इसके लिए दिस F2 इज आल्सो 1 kilogram फोर्स. देयरफॉर द फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन द पंप प्लंजर इज हाउ मच? 1 kilogram फोर्स. ओके, सिंपल वन डेटा. अंडरस्टैंडिंग द डेटा एंड जस्ट एब्रीवेट इट तो इट बिकम्स इजियर फॉर यू. ओके ओके. द क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम असाइनमेंट नंबर 2, इट इज क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम असाइनमेंट नंबर 2. दे हैव न्यूमेरिकल एज क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 इज योर न्यूमेरिकल. इन अ हाइड्रोलिक मशीन 2 pistons आर ऑफ एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शंस इन द रेशियो. ओके, रेशियो ऑफ द एरियाज मतलब लेट इट बी क्या लिखा है स्मॉलर. ओके, दे हैव रिटन स्मॉलर पिस्टन एंड अ लार्ज पिस्टन. ओके, लेट मी पुट अप दिस वे. अभी इसका एरिया आई हैव टेकन A1, इसका एरिया आई हैव टेकन A2. And what force is needed on the narrow yani chota wala piston to overcome a force of this much on the wider is larger piston ke upar force yani ke yahan ka force that is F2 is given to be kitna 100 newton. So how much force here F1 is required and they have given a very important data that A1 upon A2 is 1 upon 10. This is given to you. Okay. So normally when we were writing the formula, we used to write F2 upon F1 is equal to A2 upon A1. So instead of that, you can reciprocate it. So according to Pascal's law, you put it as instead of F2 upon F1, we put F1 upon F2. So F1 upon F2 is equals to A1 upon A2. So both the sides have become reciprocal. Now F1 we require. F2 is given 100. A1 is how much? A1 upon A2 itself is 1 upon 10. Just cross multiply. Therefore your F1 is equals to ye wala 1 upon 10 multiply by ye 100. 0 and 0 cancels. Therefore the force acting here is only 10. 10. Kuch bhi diya tha? Yahan par Newton diya hai. So this answer will also be in Newton. Therefore the force acting on the smaller piston is 10 newton. Got it? Yeah. So that was your 8th question. Next is your 9th question, 9th of the second assignment. It says the areas of the piston are this and this. Matlab smaller piston and a large piston. इसमें क्या दिया है? एरियाज आर गिवेन यानी कि A1 इसका एरिया इज 5 centimeter square एंड एरिया योर A2 इज 625 सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर. what force on the smaller piston, what force, F1 is how much, what force on the smaller piston will support a load, load yani ke a larger piston, larger piston ka force is given, how much, 1250 newton. Okay, let us see. So iske andar again according to the Pascal's law, kya hai iske andar, we know according to the Pascal's law, statement says F1 upon F2 is equals to A1 upon A2. What is F1? Don't know. What is F2? It is 1250. Is equal to what is A1? It is 5. Upon what is A2? It is 625. Cross multiply. Therefore, F1 is equals to 5 upon 625 multiply by 1250. Getting it? So, abhi 1250 therefore the force acting on the smaller piston is just 10 newton. Just by applying 10 newton we are lifting a load of 1250, and that is why it is called as a bolo padha tha na, force multiplier. Okay, this was your 9th question. State any assumption you will make in your calculation. Yahan par kuch assumption mein kuch liya to assumption mein only Pascal's law. The assumption is Pascal's law and the reciprocal part of it that we are taking. Nothing more. Any assumptions? Okay, this is your answer. Okay, now the example, the solved example number 6.8 is given. What is the solved example says? The atmospheric pressure is 75 centimeter of mercury. Matlab the height is given. The height column is given. Height of the mercury column is 75 centimeters. Okay, 75 centimeters. But ye apne ko answer express in Newton per meter square. So first we need to convert this. So this will become 75 centimeter ka will become 75 upon 100. So it will become in meter. So this is the height of the mercury column. Ek. आगे दिया है एक्सप्रेस इन न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर एंड यूज दैट डेंसिटी ऑफ मर्क्यूरी. डेंसिटी ऑफ मर्क्यूरी इज हाउ मच, 13.6 ग्राम्स पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब. नहीं चलेगा, तो इट हैज़ टू बी कन्वर्टेड, इट हैज़ टू बी इन किलोग्राम पर मीटर क्यूब. सो 13.6 किलोग्राम ग्राम्स इनटू किलोग्राम, तो डिवाइड बाय 1000 एंड इन टू सेंटीमीटर क्यूब. सेंटीमीटर थ्री टाइम्स, तो मीटर को थ्री टाइम्स बनाना पड़ेगा. तो मल्टीप्लाई बाय 100 × 100 × 100, थ्री टाइम्स वी हैव टेकन. गेटिंग इट? ये हो गया कन्वर्शन. सो इसमें अगर कट करना है तो कट कर सकते हैं. इफ़ यू वॉन्ट यू कैन कट 1, 2 and 3. सो वॉट डज इट बिकम, 13.6 × 1, 2 and 3. ओके, दिस मैनी जीरोस. ऐसे ही रखूँ और शुड आई, एंड लेट इट बी एज इट इज. अभी रहने दो. दिस हैज बिकम इन किलोग्राम पर मीटर क्यूब. ओके, व्हेन आई सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस, इट हैज बिकम इन किलोग्राम पर मीटर क्यूब. लेट इट बी एज इट इज, बाद में कन्वर्शन करेंगे उसका. एंड दे हैव आस्क्ड द वैल्यू ऑफ जी टू बी 9.8 मीटर्स पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर. तो सिंपल, वॉट यू वॉन्ट इज what is to convert into Newton per meter square. Therefore the pressure is equals to H into rho into G. Height is how much in meters? It is 75 upon 100. Into density is how much? Density is given. It is 13.6 × 1000. Leave it as it is. Into the gravity 9.8. go for the cancellation if possible. Kya ho raha hai? 75 yani 25 threes are and 25 fours are. Anything more? Yes. 4 ones are, 4 threes are 12, 0.4 fours are 16. Denominator sab khatam ho gaya. Just multiply the numerator part. I am showing you the multiplication part. Jara dekh lo. First I multiply 34. 34 into 3. 3 fours are 12, 3s are 9 and 10. 102. And multiply by 98. Multiply by 98. 8 twos are 16. 8 ones are 8. 9 twos are 18. And 9 ones are 9. Comes out to be 6999. Point after, wait a minute. Your answer is 9996 with extra थ्री जीरोस, वन टू एंड थ्री, बराबर, एंड डेसिमल आफ्टर वन एंड टू प्लेसेस, तो डेसिमल आफ्टर टू प्लेसेस कम्स हियर, सो योर आंसर बिकम्स 99960 प्रेशर, प्रेशर इज इन न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर, बराबर है. यू कैन कीप द आंसर एज इट इज, और इफ यू वॉन्ट अ फिजिकल यूनिट, अ फिजिकल यूनिट, तो डेसिमल व्हेन इट इज नॉट देयर इट इज हियर, तो यू आर शिफ्टिंग हाउ मेनी प्लेसेस, वन टू थ्री एंड फोर, तो 9.996 इंटू 10^4, 10^4 न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. बट इफ यू गो टू सी, दिस इज अप्रोक्सीमेटेड, दिस इज अप्रोक्सीमेटेड अराउंड 9.99 is 10, तो 10 × 10^4, बट 10 × 10 इज वन मोर जीरो, तो इट बिकम्स ओनली 10^5 न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. दिस इज योर टेक्सचुअल आंसर, बट यू कैन स्टॉप द आंसर ओवर हियर, दिस कैन ऑल्सो बी द करेक्ट आंसर बिकॉज दे हैव डायरेक्टली कैलकुलेटेड ऑन कैल्सी आई सपोज, तो दे हैव गॉट 1.0 × 10^5 न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर, बट द एक्चुअल डिविजन, एक्चुअल वर्किंग करके वी गेट द आंसर एज 9.996 × 10^4 न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. दिस इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 1, इसके लिए अप्रोक्सीमेटली 10, इसके लिए हम लोग ने टेक्स्ट बुक का आंसर प्रीफर किया है. ओके, सो दिस इज योर सॉल्व एग्जाम्पल पार्ट. ओके, द नेक्स्ट सॉल्व एग्जाम्पल इज योर एग्जाम्पल नंबर 6.9. हियर इट इज सेड दैट इन अ मर्क्यूरी बैरोमीटर रीड्स 75 cm. ओके, द ओरिजिनल रीडिंग, दैट इज योर हाइट, ओरिजिनल हाइट, ओरिजिनल हाइट इज, हाइट कैसे लिखूँ मैं, ओके, ओरिजिनल हाइट इज 75 cm. ओके, नाउ 3 cm³ ऑफ एटमोस्फेरिक एयर इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन द ट्यूब. सेंटीमीटर क्यूब मतलब वॉल्यूम, तो वॉल्यूम इज एडेड, वॉल्यूम ऑफ एयर एडेड इज हाउ मच, 3 cm³ इज एडेड टू इट. ओके, देन व्हाट हैपेंस, द मर्क्यूरी फॉल्स टू अ हाइट ऑफ 65, सो द न्यू हाइट ऑफ द मर्क्यूरी बिकम्स हाउ मच, फॉल्स टू 65 cm, एंड द लेंथ ऑफ द एयर कॉलम अबाउ द मर्क्यूरी, यानी कि हाइट ऑफ द एयर कॉलम इज 15 cm. सो हियर ओरिजिनली इट वॉज 65, देन इट बिकेम, ओरिजिनली इट वॉज 75, देन इट बिकेम 65. Therefore, what is the difference in the pressure? Therefore, how much pressure will be exerted? Therefore, the pressure exerted by the air on the mercury column will be how much? पहले 75 था, बाद में 65 हो गया, तो इसका मतलब माइनस करके वी गॉट 10. तो इट इज एक्टिंग विथ 10 cm ऑफ mercury. दिस मच प्रेशर इज being exerted. बराबर है. एंड also आई नीड टू फाइंड the volume ऑफ air which is enclosed. So volume of air is always area into height, because area is length into breadth, and this is your height. Area of the cross section is given, area of cross section we want, and height is given to be 15, barabar hai, height is given to be 15 cm. So the volume of air is this much centimeter cube. Okay, now since it is related to pressure and volume, we need to use the Boyle's law. Boyle's law states that when the temperature remains constant, the product of P1 V1 is equals to P2 into V2. Okay, what is the pressure originally exerted? It is 75 cm. What was the original volume? It was 3 cm³. What is the new pressure exerted? The new pressure exerted is only 10 cm ka. Into how much is the volume? Volume is this. Volume of air is this. That is area multiplied by 15. सो यू वॉन्ट दी एरिया, तो कीप दी एरिया ऑन वन साइड एंड टेक एवरीथिंग इन द डिनोमिनेटर, यानी 75 मल्टीप्लाई बाई 3 डिवाइडेड बाई ऑल द नंबर्स, यानी 10 एंड 15. वॉट डज इट गो फॉर? 15 वन जा एंड 15 फाइव जा. एनीथिंग मोर? मोर मोर जाता है, बट डोंट कैंसिल. 5 3 जा 15 अपॉन 10. 15 अपॉन 10. अपॉन 10 मीन्स पॉइंट आफ्टर वन प्लेस. देयर फॉर द एरिया हैज बिकम 1.5 सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज द एरिया ऑफ द एनक्लोज्ड एंड क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ द बैरोमेट्रिक ट्यूब. राइट द फाइनल आंसर. ओके, सिंपल वन. योर इट इज योर एग्जाम्पल नंबर 6.10, 6.10, वेर इट इज अबाउट द चेंज इन द प्रेशर, चेंज इन द प्रेशर एज द एल्टीट्यूड गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग. सो यर दे हैव सेड दैट ओरिजिनली द प्रेशर वॉज एट द सी लेवल, द एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर. सो एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर एट सी लेवल इज गिवन टू बी 76 सेंटीमीटर्स ऑफ मर्क्यूरी, एंड एट द एंड दे हैव गिवन द माउंटेन वेयर द बैरोमीटर रीड 70 सेंटीमीटर ऑफ मर्क्यूरी. सो द एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर ऑन माउंटेन, ऑन द माउंटेन इज हाउ मच? इट इज 70 सेंटीमीटर्स ऑफ मर्क्यूरी. मतलब देर इज एन असेंट, द पर्सन इज फ्रॉम द सी लेवल, ही इज क्लाइंबिंग अपस्टेयर्स. मतलब हाउ मच ही हैज असेंडेड, असेंडिंग बोलते हैं ना, असेंडिंग. सो द प्रेशर डिफरेंस, हाउ मच इज द डिक्रीज इन द प्रेशर लेवल, डिक्रीज इन द प्रेशर विल बी हाउ मच? ओरिजिनली इट वॉज 76 एंड देन इट बिकेम 70. मतलब 6 सेंटीमीटर ऑफ मर्क्यूरी का चेंज हुआ है, 6 सेंटीमीटर ऑफ मर्क्यूरी का चेंज हुआ है. सो नाउ इफ यू सी वॉट इज द क्वेश्चन, वॉट इज द हाइट ऑफ द माउंटेन, हाइट ऑफ द माउंटेन. ओके, हाइट ऑफ द माउंटेन. यहाँ पर एक काम करते हैं, वी मेक टू कॉलम वेन द प्रेशर एंड द हाइट. हाइट पूछा है ना, ओके. आई मेक दिस कॉलम. दे हैव गिवेन दैट वेन द प्रेशर फॉल्स बाय 10 मिलीमीटर्स, वेन द प्रेशर बिकम्स फॉल्स बाय 10 मिलीमीटर्स ऑफ मर्क्यूरी, मिलीमीटर्स ऑफ मर्क्यूरी पर 120 मीटर्स ऑफ असेंट. वेन अ पर्सन क्लाइम्स 120 मीटर्स, इट बिकम द प्रेशर बिकम्स 10 मिलीमीटर्स ऑफ मर्क्यूरी, बट 10 मिलीमीटर्स इज 1 सेंटीमीटर. दैट इज आई कैन से दैट 1 सेंटीमीटर ऑफ मर्क्यूरी वेन द हाइट इज 120 मीटर्स. ओके, इफ दिस इज सो, वी आर क्लाइंबिंग हाउ मच? वॉट इज द बैरोमेट्रिक चेंज? वॉट इज द प्रेशर? इट इज 6 सेंटीमीटर्स ऑफ मर्क्यूरी. तो वेन इट इज 6 सेंटीमीटर्स ऑफ मर्क्यूरी, वॉट विल बी द हाइट? देयर फॉर h is equals to how much? Therefore, if you cross multiply this, the height where on the mountain, the height of the mountain, the height of the mountain will be, this into 1 is 1 only, only required to multiply 120 into 6. It comes out to be 720 meters. So this is the height of the mountain. Simple. Already the conversion factor was given to us. That is 10 millimeters of mercury with 120 meters. जैसे 120 meters climb करोगे, 10 millimeters of mercury fall हो जाता है. Okay? So that was all. ये क्या है? What is meant by the statement that atmospheric pressure at the point is this much? State its value in Pascal. This is already given in the textbook. Assignment 3 का value, third question है. थर्ड क्वेश्चन, एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर. व्हेन वी से दैट एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर इज 76 सेंटीमीटर ऑफ मर्क्यूरी, बट हाउ मच इज 76 मिलीमीटर्स ऑफ मर्क्यूरी इन के इन पास्कल्स? इट इज 1.03 इनटू 10 रेस टू 5 पास्कल्स. सिंपल, दिस इज अ लर्निंग पार्ट. एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर इन पास्कल्स, जस्ट द कन्वर्शन डायरेक्टली इट इज गिवन इन द टेक्स्ट बुक. It is given in your textbook on the page number, but your page numbers are different, I suppose. The page numbers are different for both the schools. What we are finding is atmospheric pressure. When it is, atmospheric pressure. it is given to be in pascals. Yeah, they have already given here in pascals. The conversion factor is 1.013. It is 013 into 10 raised to 5 into 10 raised to 5. It is 0.013 into 10 raised to 5. The textbook has mentioned 03, but actually this is your answer. 10 raised to 5 Pascal. 1.013 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal, which is also called as 1 atmosphere. Which is also called as 1 atmosphere, which is also called as 1 ATM. Okay? If they ask you. Okay, there is a numerical in a part. Let us answer some more questions. In that, you have question number 30. It is same as this example. Look at this. Only the change in the numbers. The at a sea level, the atmospheric pressure is 760 millimeters. Here it is 760 millimeters of mercury. Okay. If the air pressure decreases by 8 millimeters, the air pressure decreases by 8 millimeters of mercury per 100 meters. With every 100 meters, the pressure goes on decreasing by 8 millimeters of mercury. Okay, let it be as it is. Then, if the pressure decreases by so much, then what is the height of the mountain? What is the height of the mountain? Mountain ka height chahiye. When the barometric reading is, so atmospheric pressure on the mountain is given 680 millimeters of mercury. So now what will be the decrease in the pressure? New calculation. Originally it was 760 and then minus 680. It gives you 80 millimeters of mercury. Okay. Here there is no need of centimeter. Conversion into centimeter. Okay. So here your new calculation will be pressure and height ka difference. When 100 meter of ascent is done, the pressure decreases by 8 millimeters of mercury. But when there is a decrease of 80 millimeters of mercury, then what is your height? Therefore, the height of the mountain is this into this cross multiply, that is 80 multiplied by 100 upon this 8. So it gives me 10 into 100 is 1000 meters. So this is the height of the mountain. Okay, this was your 30th question. Uske pehle ek 29th question diya hai. It is a theory question, completely a theory question. 28th and 29th, it's there in my video where I have explained you the advantages and disadvantages of mercury and then disadvantages of water not being used in barometers. So your thing is, length of water column is equivalent to this much. Water column is how much? 0.76 meters of mercury column. Okay, state the assumption made in your calculation. The density, apna jo density hai, density of water is around 10 raised to 3 kilogram per meter cube. And therefore, agar tube banana hai, then the height of the tube should be around 10.4 meters. That is a general assumption. Kyunki itna pressure is equal to the sea level. 10.4 meters ka length. Jab normal mercury hota hai, to mercury ke liye hum log 76 millimeters of centimeters of mercury bhi le sakte hai. But here, if it is water, if water is used, you need a tube of 10.4 meters. Okay. Can water be used as barometric liquid? Give reason. No, water cannot be used as a barometric liquid because of so many disadvantages, like it may stick to the glass density, the vapor pressure of water is high. So its vapor in the vacuum space will make the reading inaccurate. Or water sticks with the glass tube and wets it, so the reading becomes inaccurate. And also water is transparent, so sometimes its surface is not easily seen while taking the observations. So that is all about your chapter, that is your pressure, problems related to pressure. Okay. Haven't got the textbook, but got the PDF file of your questions. So I haven't numbered it as 1, 2, 3, 4. I have numbered according to the PDF file which I have received. Okay. So this is your problems related to pressure.